What's up, awesome YouTubers? Ryan1988 or Justin back here to do a video for you guys. And today I have a special video. I mentioned that I was going to do this video, I believe in my last video, where I was going to do a unboxing, or in this case, a semi-unboxing, of these 12 movies that I got on 4K. Fantastic price, in my opinion, because I saved $150. Pretty much, these movies, except for the codes, are brand new. The seller took out the codes, but they're brand new. The 4Ks and even the Blu-rays are in there. They haven't been played, shrink-wrapped. I mean, just awesome. And really happy to talk about them and show them off. They have been out for a while, and I originally was like, do I need these on 4K? But then I was like, you know what? I have a 4K TV. I have a 4K player. This is one of my favorite franchises, favorite universes, sagas. You probably know what I'm talking about when I say saga. So I went for it and I bought them. Pretty much $18.50 a piece if you calculate everything, and I saved $150. These still go for like $30 in the stores. So I got an excellent deal, guys. I'm really happy. Like, I'm like kid in a candy store happy. I was like that when I ordered the new Friday the 13th set, which I will do an unboxing when that comes in the mail. But yeah, I was like a kid in the candy store when I got these. I'm really excited to show these off. And I know, you know, as far as a franchise goes, there's the worst and the best, but for me, I either like the movies, really enjoy them, or love them. There's not one I dislike. So, without further ado, let me show these off. I'm going to try not to make this video too quick. I've actually already opened the box, and the seller was awesome. This is not all the bubble wrapping that he used. There's actually a lot more. He wrapped them all up. Made it safe, made sure that these came in pristine condition. So I don't know if the seller's going to be watching the video if he comes across it, but thank you. I really appreciate it. Got them all on eBay. Again, saved pretty much $150. $18.50 a piece if you calculate it all. So yeah, love it. So let's get started, guys. Let me show you. I'm going to be talking about, and I'll just do this, the Star Wars saga. Yes, guys, all of them on 4K. I splurged. I took that leap. I don't care. I'm just really happy to own these movies on 4K, because this is one of my favorite. Solo's Upside Down and Rogue One, who cares? Because this is one of my favorite universes, franchises, whatever you want to call them. Just really happy to have this. There's my thumbnail, maybe. So, just really happy to have these. So, let's talk about these real quick. I'm not going to try to make this video too long. We have the original. Well, not the original. Sorry. The prequel trilogy. Right there. You know, I know the prequels are kind of mixed bag to negative. I've always enjoyed them or loved them. Phantom Menace was the first one, the first Star Wars movie I saw in theaters. It wasn't the movie that made me fall in love with Star Wars. I'll talk about that one in a minute. But it was the first one I saw in theaters. I love these artworks, by the way. They are fantastic, amazing, so good. Again, shrink wrap pretty much. He just took the codes out. So that is awesome. Really, really, really awesome. And they all have the slipcovers, so really cool. Attack of the Clones. My least favorite of the bunch, but I still like the movie. So I still enjoy watching it with the saga, or with the whole universe. Revenge of the Sith. Now, this is one of my favorite artworks from the new artworks that they did. I love that. I think that's fantastic. I love the red. I love the black. I also love that every one of these have like their own colors to them, which is really cool. So there's that one right there. This is the one that made me fall in love with Star Wars. I saw this movie in theaters when it came out, and I fell in love with it then, and I still love it now. Top five, maybe top three favorite Star Wars movies. I'm gonna say top five. But I love Revenge of the Sith, so hands down, awesome. Here is A New Hope. This, of course, is the original Star Wars movie, the first movie of the bunch. And I love A New Hope. Hands down, just classic movie, fantastic. So I hear this is the best as far as transfers go. This is the best one. And it's just because before Disney kind of took over the rights, which they always had the right. Well, they didn't always have the rights. They had, at one point maybe like 50-50, but Fox still owned some of the rights to the movies, or they still owned half of the rights. So when Fox had A New Hope, they cleaned it up. Like they did if I'm saying the word right, a real 4K restoration. They didn't just do a 4K scan. So I've heard this is the best as far as transfers go. This is the best one. So that's awesome. I'm a completist though. So I knew if I got one, I needed to get the rest on 4K. Call me crazy, but that's me. We are all completists in our own way. And for me, this is one of those sagas that I was like, you know what? If I don't get them all together, eventually I will get them. So if I don't get them all together, I will get them. On 4K. Empire Strikes Back, my favorite of all the Star Wars movies. I love this film. Heard pretty good things about the transfer, but again, for me, it was just awesome to get them all. And for the price I got them all for, it was amazing. So, yeah, my favorite of the bunch of just like the movies in general, that's my favorite one. Return of the Jedi? Unpopular opinion, this is one of my least favorites. However, again, I either like the movies, really enjoy them, or love them. I really like the movie, so not too many problems with it. I think as far as the original trilogy goes, this is my least favorite, but still a good movie. Love the green. Again, love the colors that, they went with. I've loved the fact that all the movies have their own colors, their own look to them, so that's awesome. Then we got these standalone movies, so I'll talk about them first before I get to the new trilogy. Solo. Well, let's do this. We'll do Rogue One first, and then we'll go to Solo. There is Rogue One, which I love the movie. Solid in theaters. Awesome film. Really good, solo film in the universe. Really good prequel leading up to A New Hope. Just I love it. Fantastic prequel. Love the characters. Love drawing a blank on her name. I know I'm going to. Felicity Jones? Felicity Jones? Is that Felicity Jones? I believe. Yes, Felicity Jones. Love her in this movie. Great character. Just one of my favorites all around. I love the film, so. But yeah, there's the 4K to that. Then we got Solo. I held it up for a split second, but Solo, really like the film. Again, I enjoy a very enjoyable movie. I wish I would have saw this movie in theaters because I think it would have been a really good theater experience. But sadly, this movie failed at the box office and not a lot of people saw it. I have my theories on that. I think this was a movie that just came out too soon after Last Jedi. I think it was like 5 or 6 months after the release of Last Jedi. And I think even though, and I'll give you my opinion on Last Jedi in a minute, even though I will say, even though I love Last Jedi, a lot of fans were not happy with the movie. And I think they were just done with Star Wars for at least a while. And so Solo came out after Last Jedi. And I think between the release of Last Jedi, the fact that they released another Star Wars movie too soon, and the problems behind the scenes of this movie, I think it caused the movie to fail. at the box office, but it's a really good film. So if you've never seen it, give it a watch. I think this is just a really good prequel. The actor that they got to play Han Solo is awesome in the movie. Overall, great cast, really good surprises and cameos from characters. Just overall, very enjoyable. So looking forward to watching it on 4K. I had the previous 4K. I actually got it when my store closed down for like $5.99, but I gave my other releases to a friend of mine, and when these were coming, I knew I was going to get rid of those. So yeah, have this on 4K now. So I only watched it on Blu-ray, never watched that previous 4K I had, so looking forward to watching it on 4K. I'm sure it's going to look awesome, being that it is a newer movie. So yeah, Solo. Very enjoyable movie. I really like that. Now going on to the newer and the latest trilogy. Force Awakens. Love, again, the colors and the artwork, I love. Force Awakens, I absolutely love the film. Awesome movie, in my opinion. I've seen it like 4 or 5 times. I know over time, within the 5-year gap that this movie's been released, people criticize it for pretty much being a remake to the original film. And I could see where people can say that, it is kind of like that, but I also think it's a very groundbreaking movie. Because you gotta think there was a 10-year gap between Revenge of the Sith and Force Awakens. And I think people were just really surprised at how good the movie was. Again, over time, within the 5 years since it's been released, almost 5 years, it's been criticized for pretty much being a remake, but it was groundbreaking when it came out. I mean, I love the movie. I think it's awesome. You had returning characters from the original trilogy, you had brand new, fantastic characters coming into this trilogy or into this saga. And J.J. Abrams did an amazing job with this film. So, Force Awakens, I absolutely love that movie. Still love it today. All right, here comes the movie that I know a lot of people don't like. And I will say this before I give my opinion and what I think about the movie, which I've talked about it before. I can understand where people will dislike this movie. Do I think it deserves the hate that it gets? Because a lot of people say it's the worst of the bunch. I don't think it's the worst of the bunch. But again, I can understand people's criticism of it overall. Does it deserve like complete hate? No. Do I understand criticism of the film? Yes. But I love The Last Jedi. This is gonna get people. This is my second favorite after Empire Strikes Back. For a while it was my favorite of the whole saga. But Empire Strikes Back is still the best. I love The Last Jedi though. I think it's awesome. Again, I can understand criticism for the movie. I think Rian Johnson wanted to do his own thing, which I have respect for, but I think it also hurt J.J. Abrams because he had this timeline of what he wanted the universe to be, his three films that he wrote pretty much, or a timeline that he had of the movies. Even though he wasn't going to direct anymore after Force Awakens, he had a timeline. And J.J. wanted to do his own thing, and he pretty much scrapped anything that J. Or I'm sorry, Rian Johnson wanted to do his own movie, but scrapped what J.J. had in mind. Anyway, enough rambling. I love the film though. The first 15 minutes always get me a little bit because I think the first 15 minutes are a little bit off, but after that, I love it. So. Again, I understand criticism. Not everybody's gonna love or like the same movies you do, or that I do. But, I've had people say this is the worst of the bunch. It's not the worst of the bunch. I still love the film. You got great characters in the movie. Yes, you have, a different direction of the way Luke Skywalker is in the movie, which, again, I think even Mark Hamill said he didn't like the way he was portrayed in this movie. But overall, you got a great cast, and I love the film still. I love the red. There's a lot of red involved with this movie, and I love that. So, But yeah, Last Jedi. Again, I had this on 4K, but only paid $5.99 for it. Got rid of that. Knew this was coming, so I just got rid of that. But yeah, Last Jedi. So, enough of that. Again, I love it. And then the last one, Rise of the Skywalker. The Rise of the Skywalker. The Rise of Skywalker. There you go, Justin. Say it right. I really enjoy it. I don't love the movie. I don't think it's as bad as critics made it out to be. It's so funny. Last Jedi came out and critics loved that movie, where the fans did not. But Rise of a Skywalker, wanted to say that right, is a movie that's opposite, where critics really bash the film, or they really just dislike the movie, and fans loved it. I really like the film. I really do. I really like the movie a lot. I've only seen it a couple times. I saw it in theaters, and then when my previous 4K I had, I watched it then. But just decided to keep this one because, I wanted to get the whole 12 movies together, lined up. But yeah. So, and I remember this looking really good on 4K. So, I was not initially a fan of the slipcover when I saw it online, but looking at it now, I think it's really good. I like the matted look it has. These pretty much all kind of have a matted look to them. This one really does, if that makes sense. It's really nice. And I really like the back. I think that is cool too. But then when you take the slipcover off, you have that artwork there, which I love that artwork. So that's awesome. I had the Target exclusive, which I really liked it. But I got rid of it. I gave it to a friend of mine. He's a Star Wars fan too, so I gave him that. Kept this one because they all look so good lined up together. So, and I did not need two copies of Rise of Skywalker. So just kept this. Got a great price on all 12 of these movies, and so I'm really happy just to have the movie. So not one of my favorites. I would probably rank this middle to one of my least favorites, probably in the middle. I don't think it's, again, I don't think any of these movies are bad. I love Star Wars, so that's really cool. Very glossy, very neat. Love it. So, and again, just looks kind of nice lined up with them all. But yeah, guys, so let's see if I can get this. There we go. There is all 12 movies on 4K. Let me see if I can get a good thumbnail right there. Anyway, guys, yeah, that's really awesome. I'm so happy to have these movies on 4K. I just went for it. Sometimes you gotta take that leap, and if you love something, which I love Star Wars, I love Star Wars, I'm gonna take that leap. I have a 4K player, I have a 4K TV. If it's a franchise I absolutely love, I'm gonna upgrade them. And again, I saved $150 for these movies. $1,850 a piece, pretty much. No digital copies, which I'm okay with because I don't use the digital copies, but the 4Ks and the Blu-rays are still here. And they are, besides New Hope, which I did open, I wanted to just kind of look at it. It's my one of my favorites of a bunch. Besides New Hope, they're all still in their shrink wrap, and New Hope was before I opened it. Awesome deal, guys. I wanted to share this. I was so happy. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. You got to hear me talk about the movies. Maybe once I rewatch them, which I'm going to do that soon, I'll rank them. And I'll talk about where I rank them. So, but yeah, guys, wanted to share this. Hope you enjoyed it. Happy Friday to you all. I got something in my eye. But happy Friday to you all. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Thank you to my subscribers, both new and old. I recently, just recently, and I don't want to jinx it because sometimes subscribers will go up or down, but I recently hit 3,700 subscribers, which is fantastic. That is awesome. So, thank you guys, for subscribing, for liking the videos, for commenting, but most importantly, for watching. I'm very thankful for that. So, you know, if it wasn't for you guys, I don't know if I'd still be making videos. I've been doing it for 12 years, and while I've really, really loved making videos, especially during this pandemic, I'd say there was probably some years where I thought, do I keep going on? Do I keep making videos? I mentioned the pandemic and making videos, you know, quite more than I was before the pandemic. I think the pandemic really got me, while it's been a sad thing, it's really got me in the mood and has boosted my energy to keep going and keep making videos and make them a lot more than I was, because I think before the pandemic, before the place where I was working, before, you know, the store I was at shut down, I didn't have time to really make a lot of videos, and my energy and my focus was at work, and I was, and obviously focused on other things. But I really didn't do a lot of videos, and I really just didn't have the energy to do them as much. I did them, but there was probably like a 2 or 3 month gap when you saw a new video from me, which now, with the, you know, unfortunately with the pandemic that we have, you know, I've been at home a lot more, and I've been able to make a lot more videos, and with you guys, you know, watching the videos and, you know, subscribing and, you know, just showing your love and support, it has really boosted me to make videos more frequent. And I know that I should enjoy making videos, you know, in general, which I do. But without you guys, without your support, without your love, you know, I don't know if I would have done, you know, as many, I don't know if I would still be on here. I'm rambling, guys. I apologize. Just thank you guys for your support. Without you guys, I don't know if the channel would still be around. That's where I was going with that. And it's your support and love that really means a lot to me. I love you guys so much. And, thank you guys so much for watching. You know, subscribing is amazing, liking the videos is amazing, commenting is amazing, but watching the videos, knowing that you guys are loving them and enjoying them, puts a smile on my face, and it still boosts my confidence to keep making videos, and I look forward to making more videos, not only for me, but really for you guys in the future to come. Stay tuned, because I have a lot more planned. And I will have an update just in general on Sunday, showing off the last 2 weeks worth of movies that I've picked up. That was another thing with updates, is I'm going to not wait so long, because I tend to, like, I don't realize how much I get when I make updates, because I'll have like two big stack of things just because I wait so long. So updates will be coming more frequent when I get like a handful of titles in. And I'll just talk about them in a video. So you'll see more updates from me. I'm done with the collection overviews besides this wall right here, which I will do in October. So a lot more reviews are going to be coming. I started a review series called Movies I Love or That I Love, which I only did one, but I still plan to do a lot more of those. So that's a series that I'm going to keep doing. A lot more ranking videos. I have some really cool rankings that I've been seeing and that I want to do. Movies that I think favorite movies throughout the years I've been born or something like that. So starting from 1988 up until now, you know, talking about my favorite movie, if not one of my favorite movies from that year. So I'm going to be doing that. I've seen some other YouTubers do it. I think that's really cool. I love that. I'm also going to do a spin on that and do a horror movie one. So there's going to be two of them. I'm going to be doing just your general video where I talk about a favorite movie from each year I've been alive. I'll probably not talk about horror movies in that video because I'm going to do a October version where I'll talk about my favorite scary movie from each year, from the time I was born up until now. So plenty of videos to come, guys. Stay tuned. Once again, thank you guys so much for your love and your support. It really means a lot to me. It boosts my confidence, but I'm also happy that I've been here for 12 years and people still love to watch the videos. That really puts a smile on my face. You guys, I don't know if you guys know, but it really does put a smile on my face, and I get happy that, I've been here for 12 years and people still love to watch. People still love to comment, like the videos, but most importantly, watch the videos. And just thank you guys. I do this for fun. I do this because I love it. And I'm grateful for you guys. So grateful for you. But anyway, guys, I don't want to ramble on too long. Just thank you once again for subscribing, for loving the videos, for supporting the channel. I really appreciate it. Thank you guys so much. And as always, you guys are awesome. You guys rock. In with the positive, out the negative. Go eat some Skittles, and much love to all. Thank you.